I'm Andy Jones with Bear Creek Fisheries in Moorhead, Mississippi. We are a fingerling operation, which we grow the little bitty fish, and we also grow the food size fish, which you eat in a restaurant or at home. Here recently, in the last several years, the egret problem has gotten to be a real problem. When we're feeding fish like we are right behind me, you can see the fish on top of the water swimming around, and the birds will come in and fly in and eat the fish as we are trying to feed them. And then once they're done eating, they will settle back down and go back down the pond. We have people that ride around in trucks all day, and their job is kind of to harass them. If I got two guys riding over 100 ponds, which I have 100 ponds out here, you know, that's only one pond every few seconds that the guy can control. A laser does 5 ponds all the time, you know, over a matter of a few minutes or a few seconds, it's going back. If we don't do anything, we probably are losing 10 to 15, maybe even more percent of our fish a year off of just birds eating them out of the ponds. You know, it can get real costly on what you can do.
My name is Jonathan Henderson, farm manager for Harvest Select Catfish over here in Inverness, Mississippi. Farms roughly 900 acres of water, about 185 acres of brood fish, and the rest are in fingerling production, along with about 40, 50 acres of food fish production. Our biggest problem is probably the white egrets. Last year, we had anywhere from 5,000 to 15,000 of those on the farm. We've guessed probably 10 to 15% of our mortality in fish is due to loss to the birds. Let's say if it were 10% of our mortality, that would be about 6 million fingerlings a year. You're looking at about $750,000 worth of fish. And then it could be even higher than that. I would say that's a conservative estimate. I've been impressed so far with the results. I would say we have a 80 to 90% reduction in the amount of birds so far this year compared to last year. I've set the patterns on them and they just run on their own, and I haven't had no necessary maintenance or electrical issues or anything since we set them up. And we saw farms that did not have the lasers have a lot of birds, where we had almost none. We've been extremely happy with them, with the quality and the results from them.